Hey, Kit Factory enthusiasts, welcome to Studio Scale Star Trek Klingon Bird of Prey Update Number 3. As we start progressing towards those double digit numbers, but it's taken a while. Actually, I gotta say, this kit is going together very well and quicker than I thought it would. So, that schedule, which you see tied up for over 2 years, will be clearing out a little sooner than I thought. So for all you guys that are hesitating because you actually have to wait a little while, take that as a hint. Let's see. So today we're going to take a look at the metal armature, and we're actually beyond that, but I'm going to show you because people that have subscribed to my Facebook page actually get a first look at it, and you do have the option of friending me on Facebook. There is a link on this website. A lot of people thought that, this is something funny to bring up, because I no longer posted them on YouTube, that my membership, my viewership would go down to like, and actually, if anything, it's risen. So to the guy that was like, I don't know whether it was hostile posting it or just saying it because he thought it was actually going to happen, dude, you were wrong. And if anything, the popularity has really increased. Really happy about the website. Tom Conklin from an extension did a fantastic job on the site. He's posted just about everything I want him to post on there. Of course, when this video is posted, for all of you that registered with your email contact and all that, will be notified. Even YouTube at a certain point, because they weren't real happy with me for whatever reason it is, probably the same reason that they killed my monetization to discourage me from hanging around, weren't doing as well as a job as I know Tom is with his system. So as soon as this is posted, you will know. Okay. So what we have to show you today is some of the stuff that's coming up next. The motor system for this wing assembly, because I wanted to motorize the wings, is being machined right now as we speak over the last couple days. Edward Holt, also known as Mr. Wizard, has been working me steadily on that. And he's pretty confident we're going to be okay. I've transferred a whole lot of data back and forth. There are some things I will have to do on my end. But as long as it's something that comes with a good set of instructions, I can do pretty much anything following the instructions. So, and if something I need to do on my end, just, you know, make it clear and I'll be able to do it. I can machine just about anything. As far as this kit goes, I've been kind of feeling like I'm building a motorcycle. A whole lot of metal involved in this, more than I thought. What else? And I'll show you this. There's a segment of I-beams on the lower wing where I found out I was looking for the part, and Steve says, well, that's not included. So I'm having Elliot Brown whip me up those little H or T-beams, depending how you look at them, to complete that particular section. And that's cool. I just didn't realize that part didn't come with the model, and I spent quite some time looking for it. But that's been resolved. So I'm going to show you everything but that at this point. It's going to take Elliot a couple days to get that together. But Elliot Brown, my friend, is an absolute whiz, and he runs Fedoratron, which also used to be Kingston Vacuum Works. And although he doesn't get into selling the vacuum forming machines anymore, because everybody whines and moans about prices, and God, do I know about that. He's terrific at creating parts, and actually has been helpful on just about every project I can think of a while back that had any kind of impact at all, especially the bigger ones. So, Elliot, thank you very much for taking care of that for me. So, let's see. What else? So, back here you can see a couple of my Klingon collection props. This is actually just a Playmates toy, the ship over here. And that's just kind of giving me an overall reference for the way the body goes together. It's not super accurate, but it does show me segments. And here's a really interesting collectible. Klingon dagger. Real nice piece. Real dagger. I also saw a film. This is a standard Klingon dagger where Mario Van Peebles in some kind of Terminator-like film where he's an android or whatever had one of these. So it's been used more than once, and I've got this nifty little stand I made for it. One of my little collectibles, and I thought I'd share that with you. I like to put something on that shelf over there, and I like to hang out in front of the air conditioner unit because then it doesn't block any of the screens, which is why I'm always a little offset. So, a little inside information for you. Oh! What else? I'm going to show you some of the hardware that's involved. The studio right now is pretty much laid out with everything that I'm actually using. Over here, I have the next step, which is the gun assembly, the laser cannons on the side of the wings, because I'll show you where I'm at. The wings, although could be completed within a day or two, I'm hesitant to do because I don't know about the linkage for the power system that's going to raise and lower the wings. So now I'm not sure about how far I should take the assembly for the wings, because the motorized assembly that's coming could force me to do some alterations. So all the wings are put on there with a tapped Allen screw, which can be removed. The panels can be removed. Everything is accessible, let's put it that way. And whenever I'm dealing with a maybe situation, I make it so things are accessible and not locked down till basically we know what we're doing, things are finalized, things are installed, and then we go into the covering up the countersunk holes and all that and unifying everything. And that's pretty much towards the end when we start getting into aesthetics and painting. So let me see. I think we'll move on from here. We don't need to go into blah, 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 blah a whole lot. Other than, let's move on. All right, so here we are at the world famous lift table. There we go. Something I acquired from when my wife worked in the hospital business, which is a hospital lift table, which has gone through several modifications, but extremely handy. I've often said that a lot of the medical stuff that's out there for operating rooms and all that just applies for high-end modeling so much it's scary. And when they sell this stuff off, because their square footage operating room floor value in comparison to the equipment they go through constantly makes these things, which is, this thing probably cost $5,000-$6,000 originally when they bought it, you can pick up it for a song for like $20-$30, which is, I know, just doesn't seem right, does it? But I managed to acquire two of these. So here's our bird laid out. Right now on this side is not quite completed yet. On the other side, I've actually gone through the process of getting the assembly all ready to assemble. And I'm gonna go ahead and change camera angle and all that and show you that. Here's our retention post that I've managed to get through into the frame past this thing. This thing's only on here temporarily because there's some mechanicals going in there. And I'm also gonna show you the lighting that's gonna have to go through the wings, which is why I haven't completed the wing section at all, or completely, I should say. Note that all the wing assemblies have not been glued on yet. And what's holding them on right now is tapped Allen stainless steel hardware, which I've gotten to the point since I tapped it that I can take off, put on, take off, put on, pretty much for at least a half a dozen times before it starts to wear out. And once all the internals are done and we're ready to finish up, those will be puttied over with epoxy, and never know they were there. Plus they add to solidity, rigidity, and whatever. When you have the aluminum frame like I've done it, which has been considerably cut down for a weight aspect for the motorized wing assembly, these panels going on top and being very secured add to the overall strength. Now, a lot of people were saying something along the line that when I mount the guns on the end and all that, there would be some sag. No, believe me, this stuff is extremely strong, and although I've been told it is aircraft aluminum, I have a feeling it's some kind of alloy, because I've never had that much trouble cutting through just standard aluminum, and even drilling is difficult to go through this stuff. I've had to use some fairly high-end bits on it. It's broken a few die, tap and die kits. And if it is standard aluminum, it's damn fine standard aluminum, aircraft aluminum. I think it's more of an alloy mix with a higher content of actual steel or metal in there. Rarely meet up this kind of resistance on just straight up aluminum. Anyway, so let me change angle here. I just wanted to get you an idea of the scale of this thing. And we're going to close up on what I'm working on now as far as the wing assembly, what's been done. And then I'm going to flip it around and show you on the stand just how big this guy is. Yes. It's gay. Okay, moving on. All right, so here is the side that has had quite a bit of work done today. So what it is, this is the lower wing assembly. Now, I did find out that back here, all these structurals, and these are basically just slats, don't come with the kit. So I've got Elliot Brown right now creating me what's called H-beams, which is what's over here. And there's, 11? Or 22 of them. So there's 11 per side. Some of them are aiming this way. And of course, these guys are going that way. I've already measured out and everything, so these parts will be in a couple days. Elliot Brown's really good about returning things, and you can see his site at fedoratron.com. And he's just been invaluable, and he's literally called the Kit Factory North, because Elliot, although gets a very small paycheck, as in this much, Elliot is part of the family. So here's what we've got going here. As you know, the wing assembly is right here. So this was cut out to cover up the hinges. See that? And over here, this wing panel is removable. And the top wing panel has been attached. But again, because it's Allen threaded bolts done with a tap and die, these can all be removed and everything like that. So what's going on with this is that from looking at the model reference, this flush in the front is the way the model looks. There's no features here other than that, but right here, and let me get the parts for that, there are two spotlights, and they kind of congregate right about here, I recall from the image, and I may be posting an image up there so you can see what I'm talking about. These two guys here, and I was looking, you know, there's no instructions with this kit, but with the picture reference, yeah, you know, the parts are pretty self-evident as to what it is. These two guys are the housings for the lights, and so what I have to do now, if you take that in consideration, is to run my wiring through like I was going to, and actually drill through this metal to mount two ultra bright spotlights approximately here to get that lovely wing effect with the two spotlight lighting. So that's coming up. Also, there's gonna have to be a wire run through here all the way to the end to power up the laser cannons, which are on the end of the wing. Now, I've got Ralph Tenna at Tenna Controls, who is developing a system by which the remote control will activate the lasers with a momentary switch and turn on the basic functions that I denoted to him. And I'm really appreciative because Ralph puts up with me. So I've got Ralph working on the remote control system for this. This guy just doesn't want to stay up there. But these two spots will be right here. Once I've drilled through the metal for a receptacle for a 1/8 inch ultra bright LED, these guys will be here and give you the effect that the movie prop gave you. So now let me go to the other side and show you how I went about doing this. These little fellows, until they're glued, are just going to make me look like an idiot. And again, this side here, it's pretty hard to line it up exactly. I opened it up a little tiny bit for flexibility. It was basically lined up really well. My bolt clearance at first I thought was off, but once you put on the top panel, it's just right. Because I was looking at the pictures that Steve Nyson provides for the assembly of it. He doesn't have a clear set of instructions, but he does have a step-by-step picture thing over on his Facebook page, as well as his site page there. And sure enough, once you put the panel on and all that, and he was showing basically a button or a round top bolt, and that's what I used, a little bit bigger. I used aircraft lock nuts on it because I want my stuff to be secure, and it clears just fine once you've got the clearance done and all that. Perfect. So that's, will probably be epoxied on. Don't need to be doing Allen bolt stuff when we're actually dealing with putting things on the panel. I just want the panel itself to be removable in case I need to get some kind of mechanicals in there. So let's move on to the next section. All right, so when I start, let me get this chair out of the way. Oh, pretty big studio, but seriously, not big enough. Need a bigger one. Send money. I should do a startup. Get Papa Smurf a bigger studio. Yes. It's a thought. Okay. So when we started off, I realized that there are bolt placements here, which basically line up with what I did, because really, once you measure out the way it's supposed to be, everything lines up pretty well. You know, it's self-explanatory at a certain point. You see what I mean if you're building this kit, and you'll notice that when you overlay it, sure enough, and I didn't notice these till afterwards, everything lined up perfect. So, no doubt about that one. So what happens is I realize, at first I thought, well, maybe I need to take these off and put this over because I saw the drilling things, but however, to get everything flush, no, it's a cutout situation, which is what I did on the other side, as you saw. And although these line up pretty well, it was a good idea to widen them out to make sure everything cleared. And since I'm using aircraft lock nuts, which are slightly taller than the button bolts I saw that he was using, I thought that was a good idea too. So that's how that's done. And overlays like that and blah, blah, blah. And there you go. So that would be both wings assembly here. Now on this post, and let me move the camera over for that. Let me see if I can reach over. And hey, talk about slick, slick, slick. Okay. And this pole, which is slightly bigger than the one that I think was used in the prior version, I wanted to have a really, really good thick pole because this thing is quite heavy. Also note that this thing is going to have some detailing on it, some Klingon symbols I talked about, whether they're imprinted on it or adhered to it, I'm not sure yet. But this thing is going into a four-sided pyramid kiosk, which will have display screens and the controls on it. And overall, a really, really cool display that I've designed for this. It's such an ostentatious, big, whammy kit with a whole lot of presents. I really wanted to do it justice. And my client at this point, who is a fellow from China, has also said that, you know, if there's an American investor interested to take an offer and see what happens. What's prohibited for him is customs are very rough over there. They tend to destroy things sometimes when they're coming through, especially from America, and that the shipping costs are quite high. So if somebody in the States is interested as I build this, please contact me, let me know. Ultimately, it goes to him. However, if somebody was to say, hey, I'd really like that, and can you contact him? Do so, and here's my email, and let me know. I'm pretty sure as time goes by that you'll see that this is a very desirable project. But I'll leave it at that. At worst, he's going to get the project for his hobby store over there in China. And since it was built for him, I kind of like to see him get it. But if not, whoever gets it, I hope you appreciate it. So now let me flip it around, put it on the stand, and give you an idea what it looks like from the other way. All right, moving on. All right, so again, to give you an idea just how big this thing is, right now what I've got is a torsion bar holding up the wings, and basically this is pretty close to what attack span, or attack stance as it's known, is going to be. Of course, when I hope this thing isn't going flying up, there we go, the flight mode is something along that line, and the mechanicals that Edward has designed, will allow for this and for that. Now, this is the wing end part, and I believe, yes. And I've already allowed there for be an inset. And this guy here is gonna go over here. Let me see, let me aim this a little bit better. Yes, and there's still an insert here, yes. And I believe, God, sorry guys, I'm trying here, blind wise. Okay, there we go. And there's where that wing end and then the cannon will be right here. So the lines have to be run through there so the laser cannon fires. And that's what that's gonna do on both sides. So the mechanicals are actually being laid out to install in here. He's considering a whole lot of options on that, but we've basically got it pinned down so that a lot of the assembly, as you know, the baffles go right here. And a couple of the baffles are gonna be actually reproductions made in metal, which are going to hide a mounting block that's inside the wing, which I will recess to the point, again, you won't know it's there. And everything will be remote control, or at least in this case, push button activated, so that the function will work correctly. And what a great option. Again, the client didn't opt for that and didn't pay for that, but I wasn't going to build this thing without thinking about, you know, what can I throw his way? He's been like really super generous with me. And I said, you know, somewhere along the line, I'm gonna throw something extra at you for having sent payments sometimes. And I was like, I'm broke, send money. And he did. So I promised him a couple extras. So the motorized wing assembly is a pretty big extra. And I hope he appreciates it. And like I said, if somebody else buys the model out from under him, I'm sure they'll appreciate it. Because it is a really cool option. As far as I know, haven't seen that anywhere yet, although I've seen some pretty cool motorized stuff from other people. Jason, for instance, did the ramp and the guns on his Falcon and all that. And Jason, you're awesome, man. You're a great builder. So let's see. Let's move to the table where I'll show you the very next step, which is assembling the guns. Now, the actual laser guns and all that are mostly resin and all, but they also incorporate brass tubing, and I have to aim that laser beam right down that brass tubing to get the effect I'm looking for. So let's take a look at that. Move it on. And just as give you a reference idea of what's involved, this is just some of the hardware involved in creating at least even just the wing assembly, and of course some of the later mechanical stuff that's coming up. And that is, my friends, some of the stuff that I've had to acquire. Right there is the parts I use just for doing the tapping. There's a nice tapping kit I picked up, which I'm glad I did, because it's gonna come in handy when the motorized section comes up. Some of the hardware, of course the paint you've already seen, and the chargers for all the gadgets that I'm using right now. So that's just to take a look at the hardware involved in building this kit. So this is not strictly what I would call a out-of-the-box glue kind of project, okay? Moving on. All right, so here's all the gun parts laid out, and there are quite a few of them. Of course, the guns were made up, and let me see here. This is a Playmates toy. It's not super accurate, but it does give me an idea of the layout. There are twin cannons, let's see, on the one side, and then there's the main gun. Now the main gun, actually, this shaft here and this curled part here, this curved part, see it right there, is made up of brass tubing. Now, over the years, I've learned that a whole lot of these kits require brass tubing. So right now, what we're looking at is something along this line, and then there's this and all that, and then our twin cannons are coming out and all that kind of stuff. And then you need to have a brass gun. Now the brass gun is gonna be made up of these little brass parts. I get these from Hobbytown USA. You can actually go in there, and they have bags of this stuff, along with bags of parts and all that, and greebles, and they are truly, truly useful. And I'm not sure which dimension yet. It's something between this and this diameter. And of course, I'm not being super specific here, But let me see. I believe this is the emitter for it. This one's not quite right. Ah, there you go. And this will be the size that I'm working with. And they'll be cut to size and whatever. One of them will have to be curved. I do have a pipe bending tool, which will accommodate that. But you can see these, between this and this, these are all the components for each end wing gun. And of course, I have to aim the lasers through this thing, which is tricky. Platform. Yes, it's a platform that I use to roll around on. The concrete floor here being an old garage is not all that straight. So, and I believe, yeah, this is also a good length of it because that's what I'm going to need. And again, perfect. That's what I need. And I use some sizes that are very popular. We're probably looking at about that long, and then I need to use a slightly smaller piece for the curvature. But I have quite a selection of these guys. And I'm running low, so I have to order some more. Actually, maybe go visit and see some guy there that always gets annoyed with my presence because I ask too many questions. So I suppose that about covers it for now. Yes, I'm right here. And then we'll see. I don't know if there's a funny or not, but I'm glad I got to tell you what's up. And we'll have something else soon, but it gives you an idea where we're at. And it's actually moving along a whole lot faster and better than I thought it would. So I thought it would take a year, but I'm thinking more along 6 to 7 months at this point. So have a nice week. Papa Smurf out. More soon. Take care.
Q. Good morning, boys and girls. It's dawn here. I woke up this morning, came upstairs in the studios in shambles. Obviously, he's made one of his little films. Well, I was looking around, and I noticed there was all kinds of goodies in that. I'm trying to put track back together, okay? You can stop sending me emails. He's in the vat. There's hardly any brain matter left. Why you want a walking doorknob around, I don't know, but fine, I'll make another one. But I learned something. This Elmo fellow, well, I'm not getting anywhere near him. Too damn good a shot. So I was looking around, and Papa's got all kinds of things in here, you know, lasers, toys, cameras, bloody cameras. And I found this lovely little toy. So I put on some micro nukes. Shh, not supposed to have the plutonium. So what I'm going to do is, I know he's out there somewhere, I'm going to stalk him with infrared, and when I close in on him, I'm going to nuke him. Coming back from a cellular death on that level. Doubt it. It's going to be a tiny bit of noise, a little bit of fallout, a small nuclear mushroom cloud, but no one would notice, I'm sure. It's very early. Just because something about 1,000 times as bright as the sun lights up the morning, it should be okay. So, I'm going to launch it. The detector says he's right over here. Probably taking a nap or something. Yeah, nap this, you... PG. And I'm going to send out the remote. Get in close, stun him with the laser, and then nuke him. Can't live through that. Can't do it, man. It's not like the Martian War Machine or something. This doesn't have a whole lot of armor. And then maybe, I don't know, maybe it'll launch him back into space, and this time it doesn't come back. Well, anyways, let's give it a shot.
Thank you.